Canfield Drive is the street where Michael Brown was killed. It's also the name of a new play being performed by the Black Rep. Canfield Drive is the second world premiere of a play based on events following Michael Brown's killing that St. Louis audiences have seen. The first was playwright and performer Dale Orlander Smith's Until the Flood at the Repertory Theater of St. Louis in 2016. Both Orlander Smith and the writers of Canfield Drive, Kristen Adele Cunningham and Michael Thomas Walker, spent months and more in the St. Louis area interviewing people and researching news reports about the event and reactions to it. Orlander Smith condensed the results of her research into half a dozen or so individuals she created based on those she interviewed. Cunningham and Walker have taken the more usual approach to dramatizing a historical incident, creating a dramatic spine out of a fictional conflict between two journalists on a television program called Battleground. Imani Duncan Ward is a black woman, Brad O'Connor is a white man. Each gives us the arguments we've heard before. Michael Brown was an unarmed teenager getting ready to start college who was walking away from the policeman with his hands raised when he was shot. Michael Brown was a thief who tried to grab the policeman's gun and was attacking the policeman in a rage when he was shot. If you followed the Ferguson story, you'll be familiar with most of what's in Canfield Drive. Playwright Cunningham plays Imani, Christopher Hickey plays Brad, Eric Connors plays the host and moderator of the TV program. They also, along with Amy Louie, play many others, most of them real people of the St. Louis region, the black police chief of Ferguson, the white mayor of Ferguson, politicians, religious leaders, educators, activists, ordinary people trying to make sense of what happened, trying to justify their responses. As I say, you probably know all this, but the playwrights have done an excellent job of selecting and condensing and bringing it all together in the dramatic arc of the education of the white male journalist. The statements from the real people expand on several dramatic scenes that trace that education. Some scenes are the arguments on TV between the two journalists. One particularly effective scene has Brad driving Imani home at night after work when they're stopped by two police because they sort of match a description of a white male and a black prostitute. Now Brad begins to understand in his gut something of what Imani has been telling him about African Americans and the police. In another scene, Connors plays a waiter when the two journalists stop for a drink. The waiter, played broadly by Connors, seems to be a little comic relief until he tells about his own encounter with the police and the bullet he still carries in his gut from that encounter. All four actors perform splendidly. Marjorie and Peter Spock's set reproduces the memorial of flowers and stuffed animals on Canfield Drive, decorating an arched bridge that director Ron Himes uses effectively to transition through multiple scenes with projections of the neighborhood, the protests, the TV show logo. Jim Berwinkle's lighting clarifies those transitions, as do the varied costumes by Marissa Perry. Kareem Deans made smart choices in his sound design. The play Canfield Drive will not be the last word on what happened on Canfield Drive, but it is a helpful step along the way to our understanding of it. It's good drama, too.
Yes, and it was heartening to see that a change of mind could occur in the play. I hope it happens in the world, too.
Yeah, very good.